In this video, I want to test some 50 Hz or 60 Hz transformers and want to study whether they can also work on other frequencies. So there's also a kind of, say, resonance ID in this video. We are searching for the resonance frequency where such a 50 Hz transformer can transform its energy at its best from the primary to the secondary coil. Here are all these primary coils, 2 ohms, 4 ohms, 65 ohms, and the secondary is here 700 ohms. Of course, all DC values measured with a DC ohms meter, 55 ohms and 65 ohms. So it could be an idea that these transformers look exactly the same. But are their properties the same? So how does this transformer act not on 50 Hz but on, say, 300 Hz? Does it transport energy from the primary to the secondary on that higher frequency? Higher compared to for where it was made. Anyway, the same question here and the same question here, and the whole setup is here. 2 transistors, the schematic, I will show the schematic, a bias potentiometer. In fact, it's a power Darlington. That power Darlington is driven by my square wave generator. The video about that unit is on YouTube. The schematic is also on YouTube. And you can set here all kinds of values. The output level between 0 and 12 volts. The duty cycle. The frequency here. Etc. Because these transformers are made for 50 Hz. I've taken this generator that can only make frequencies up to, say, 900 Hz, because such a transformer can never be brought into a good oscillation on frequencies higher than, say, 900 Hz or so. That is all to do with the way these transformers are constructed. A heavy metal core here, laminated, by the way. So when the field has to change its direction, and that's always the case with AC, the field has to change its direction, there is such a big back current, electromagnetic force, EMF back current, that the core cannot change the frequency very quickly. Anyway, the schematic is here. With the transistors that I used. The first and very, very simple test is this test. This test. Take the transformer, connect your noble gas lamp here. And when I talk about noble gas lamp, I mean these kinds of lamps. Here, there's a lot of electronics inside. Take it out so that you only have the bare lamp. And I've done that here. All the electronics are gone. It's only the bare lamp. And here we have, in fact, the same situation. No electronics built in. Only the bare, say, noble gas lamp, neon tube, etc. is there. The schematic again. The first simple test is make a button switch, a resistor to safeguard the current that can flow, connect your noble gas lamp on the secondary with the high ohms winding, push that button switch, and when you see that lamp flash and light up, you have a transformer that is usable to be used in a noble gas lamp application, with in case of such a 50 Hertz transformer, by its original frequency anyway. That will work good. This is the setup that is showed here. Darlington bias potentiometer. Here we look at the scope and the counter. Square wave generator. The Darlington drives the transformer on a certain frequency and duty cycle that is set with the square wave generator. And here we can see whether that lamp performs properly, gives out light or doesn't give out light. First experiment is this transformer here. Hooked up that lamp, hooked up now the wires to the driver circuit. We are looking on 376 Hertz. This is the waveform that is sent in. And I will switch out the light, and let's see whether we can get any energy via this transformer here. It's now in the dark, of course, anyway. This transformer, this one. So I change now the duty cycle. And you can perhaps hear the frequency change. I change again the duty cycle. Change the output level. Supply voltage. Supply voltage here 11 volts. But this lamp does not work. And that means that this transformer, though it looks quite the same as this transformer, doesn't work. It's not suitable. We go to the next transformer before my camera runs out. And when it runs out, I will stop the video. So, again, this transformer. We see the waveform, and let's look whether we can set this lamp, and here it works. I'm changing now the bias of the circuit. You can see and hear that this transformer does work, and it works on 338 Hertz. This is the waveform, sorry, the energy that is sent into the driver. So with this setup, you can examine the properties. Let's change the duty cycle. Too high frequency. Output level to the driver, of course, that has an effect. This is the ideal level to drive the driver. And it's always very important that you look at the amperimeter. The best energy transformation is, of course, there when there is a lot of light, a low current, and the lowest voltage possible. So that's important. Now it's 1 ampere at 10 volts. Say it takes 10 watt. This is the waveform. But sometimes you can get out even the same amount of light with a lower, far lower current, and even sometimes with a lower voltage. That depends, of course, also on the ratio of the windings. This transformer worked. I go to the next transformer, that's here, 700 ohms is the secondary winding. The primary is 65 ohms. It's originally a 24 volt transformer. And you can see the lamp lights up properly. We don't hear a beep. The frequency is 494 Hz. The waveform sent into that circuit is this. So in fact we have here a quite good energy transport given that higher frequency on which that transformer is driven. Was made for 50 Hz but also performs good in terms of energy transportation of 500 Hz. That is also to do, apart from the windings ratio, with the physical dimensions of the transformer. This transformer has a smaller laminated weak iron core, and that means in general that it performs better on somewhat higher frequencies, between say 50 Hz and 1 kHz. So let's look. Here we have also a smaller current. Let's look at the current while we change the duty cycle. Here is a kind of ideal moment. Again, change of the duty cycle. You can see a higher current. The voltage drops somewhat down, but there is less light. And now we have a smaller current with more light. So the resonance properties are better on that other frequency. So let's switch back to all the frequencies that we have here. This is 5, that is 5 Hz approximately. It flashes 28 Hz, 109 Hz, 180 Hz, 470 Hz, and that's more or less the maximum. So when you develop such a circuit, for instance, and want to make such a noble gas lamp light up, take the transformer, do the simple test, or use a square wave generator. It has, by the way, to have a quite good amount of voltage out. That's also, for instance, important. I lift up that output voltage now. And you see that it lights up less. There's also an ideal output voltage. Not alone here when you drive it with such a generator, but also when it self-oscillates. The bias here, I change now the bias, it stops. And here it starts again. So also the bias is critical when you drive it with such a driver circuit or even with a self-oscillating circuit. Anyway, I hope I could explain it a little bit. Wish you luck.